Sometimes the buffering thing is... There we go, we're definitely live now. Hey, and welcome back, everybody, to some more Let's Stream WWF WrestleMania 2000, which I have not played in quite a while. With your host, as always, Madrybread, and returning special guest co-host, Duven.
Hello.
Now, Duven, I actually forgot to ask you before, but how much do you know about J-E-F-F-J-A-R-R-E-T-T Jeff Jarrett?
Not a lot, actually.
Did you know that's how he spells his name?
I hate him now.
He spells his name like an asshole. But Jeff Jarrett's an awesome wrestler, and an awesome dude in general. This is the very last game that Jeff Jarrett was ever in terms of WWE games, because shortly after the making of this game is when he almost essentially robbed Vince McMahon. Rightfully so, actually, when you know the context.
Yeah.
In short, basically what happened was the whole reason he came back to WWE is because he was promised a main event feud with Stone Cold Steve Austin during the Attitude Era.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, we appreciate how talented you are, we're gonna use you. And then his contract is almost up, and the current gimmick they had him with is that he hates women and thinks they should all be barefoot and pregnant in the kitchen. So, believe it or not, he wasn't happy with the direction his character was going, and he was sick of all the false promises, so his contract had expired, he was going to WCW, but he was the Intercontinental Champion, and he had one more match, but his contract had expired one day prior.
Mm-hmm.
So he had to wrestle without a contract that day. So what he did was, an hour before the pay-per-view was gonna go live, he went to JR, and he said, I'm not on contract. I don't technically have to wrestle. You remember all those promises you made me? Yeah. You know how you already agreed to pay me for the next 6 pay-per-views? Yeah. Double it. Double it or I'm not wrestling. And he's like, I'm gonna have to go get Vince. So Vince shows up, walks up to him, and he said, Vince, I don't have to wrestle tonight. You don't need to pay me a dime. I can hand you this belt and walk out of this building. But you and I both know that you want a conclusion to this whole Intercontinental thing, and I'm holding the belt. So, you pay me double what we agreed on, and I wrestle this stupid match. And Vince wrote him the check. That's the money he used to start TNA a few years later. It was a check for about $1 million.
A million.
Wow.
And Jesus
by
Christ.
The way, when he got signed to WCW, Russo paid him, like, a solid, like, $2 million or something, because Russo always looked at Jeff Jarrett as a main event player. In fact, like, 2 months later in WCW, he was world champion. Russo rightfully looked at him as a world champion contender, as he is damn good. However, WCW was already fucking sinking like the Titanic by then.
Yeah, they were.
It was unsalvageable by that point. They had a year left in them before they were dead.
Yep.
And it was
going just like, fuck it, I'll make my own company.
That was probably around the time of the storyline where the Ultimate Warrior showed up in the mirror, and everyone was crazy, that or only Eric Bischoff was crazy. And and the Ultimate Warrior is magic, and lives in a mirror, in a bathroom of an arena.
He's a Scooby-Doo villain.
Essentially, yes. God. As if we haven't been talking enough about Scooby-Doo and wrestling as of late.
I know, I'm kind of tired of it now.
Yeah, alright, let's get going with this whole thing. Can you confirm for me on the Twitch channel, by the way, that the stream is working properly? Because the chat is quiet. Oh no, chat's talking now. Alright, let's get started. So we're on an 8-match win streak here. We've had no titles, and the current champions are WWF Champion is The Rock. Tag champions, the Hardy Boys. This was their first game. This was when their manager was Michael Hayes. Intercontinental champion, Godfather. European champion, Midian. Weird. Hardcore champion, Al Snow. This would be when he had Help Me written on his head backwards.
So it would be... Implay.
This would also be when his hair was blonde.
Okay, I can't imagine Al Snow with blonde hair.
Let's mock the horrible booking. So this is Raw is War. Duven, you're on Windows, aren't you?
Windows?
Yes.
Yeah.
Do me a favor. Open up the calculator application.
Okay.
This is going to be fun.
Hold it, give me a minute. Give me, well, a second. Calculator. Now, why are we doing this exactly?
Okay. I want you to have that calculator open, and we're going to tally up the runtime of every match on Raw tonight to see how long was Raw. Alright? Alright. So, first match, tag match, Jeff Hardy versus Matt Hardy, D'Lo Brown and Mark Henry. Let's just skip that. Okay, so that was a 19 minute and 24 second double countout draw match as your curtain jerker. Oh my god, that's lame. Okay, so put
19 minutes and 24 seconds.
Yeah, yeah. And we'll just calculate it by minutes and seconds, I guess.
Yeah.
And the next match is Scott Taylor, Scotty Too Hottie, pre-Scotty Too Hottie, against Chaz. Mm-hmm. That was a 37 minute countout.
What the fuck? What?
You see a lot of this.
Jesus.
Okay. Next is Jeff Jarrett versus Al Snow. So I'm playing this one because I'm Jeff Jarrett. Undefeated. Okay. And we're against Hardcore Champion here. So we're finally. This may be the first match of any grandeur we've been put in. Let's see if I can remember the controls, because they're pretty terrible, because this is an N64 game that I'm playing on a gamepad that tries to mimic the PlayStation 3.
Indeed.
And I start the match, of course, with a low blow.
Yeah, the N64, like, I know No Mercy used the N64's D-pad, which was really strange, because no other game on the N64 used the D-pad.
Yeah.
Ever.
Which is okay with me, because I prefer the D-pads to analog sticks, actually.
Yeah, especially the N64's analog stick. It was really, really bad.
Well, that and mine got ruined really, really fast thanks to Mario Party 1.
I did not have Mario Party 1,
Mario
frankly.
Party 1 was awful.
Yeah,
it Mario was Party really 1. Awful. Like, there's a reason everyone talks about how great, like, 2 and 3 are. It's because 1 was terrible.
Yeah, 1's...
There were like
One's
four
bad.
Minigames that were just rotate the control stick so hard it blisters your hand and ruins your controller.
In this minigame, burn your hand. Just set it on fire. Yeah, it was not good. I used to really love Mario Party. Then I realized quickly that I had no one else to play it with and that I was really bored and depressed, so I stopped buying them.
I don't know what the most recent one I have is. Maybe 5 or 6, I don't know.
Yeah, me too. Last one I got was 5. Then after that, I was just like, ugh.
You know what? I think that might be the last one I got. It was good, though. I really liked that the minigame mode thing where you could, like, make a car and, like, battle each other with, like, a BattleBot-style thing. That was fun. All right.
My favorite
I am
thing is with...
absolutely beating the dog shit out of Al.
Yeah. He's not doing too well right now.
All right, I'm just going to finish with a stroke.
You know, you technically kind of just both are like the same person. Okay, actually, I just got to look at Al's face, and it was like a complete dope.
There we go. Fucking... Okay, I'm going to blame that one on... I'm going to have to blame that one on Jeff Jarrett. He kind of put his foot on the rope there.
Yeah.
Whoa. Aha!
The rope breaks are such shit in these games, because it's like the ropes have just phantom hitbox.
Yeah, sometimes the rope breaks can be really annoying. Yeah. Usually the magic to it is if you try and grab them from the opposite direction of where they're touching the ropes, they'll tuck in their body a little bit and won't touch the ropes. So if their feet are touching it, try and pin them upside down by the head and they'll tuck their legs in.
Cool.
Yeah, that's the way that I try and go for it. It's better than trying to like maneuver them around. And if you're grabbing them at the side, then you just kind of have to hope. What the fuck? Did the ref just stop counting the pin because Edge is doing a run-in? No! Why is Edge with Al Snow? What the fuck is occurring?
It's
okay, Deborah's doing a run-in on my behalf! What the fuck?
And now this crazy woman is just kind of sprinting around, not doing anything.
Yeah. I'm trying to remember what my button to get out of the ring is. I mapped it to something weird, probably. Is it?
I don't
no?
think you're gonna make it out of this one.
Again,
all I see.
Deborah, kick his ass! She's not even a wrestler, she's a manager. Oh god!
Well, shouldn't have got
Edge
in the ring
beating
then.
Women! Fuck you, Al Snow. Well, good replay on that low blow. It totally hit. This isn't going well.
No, not really. And yeah, great jump off the turnbuckle. What is even happening?
I don't know. Where's the disqualification?
Apparently, as long as it's Edge, then uninterrupted, that probably counts.
Spear me now, asshole! Deborah got him! Yes! Yes! Deborah with the run-in.
The ultimate wrestler.
Yeah.
Deborah.
You may remember her as
apparently nothing.
Hold on, why would you remember Deborah?
You wouldn't, exactly. You may remember Deborah as...
She was Stone Cold's manager once.
Once?
Yeah. At this time, her gimmick would be that she loves being objectified. It was a weird gimmick.
Well, she'd be loved on the internet right now.
Okay, if you thought that the current day WWE is kind of sexist, you should have seen Attitude Era.
The Attitude Era is known for such great quotes as "China, you big bitch."
My favorite Triple H quote.
"You big bitch."
Right behind Kane, "You're a murderer."
What?
That was right before he pretended to be Kane and fucked a corpse. As Triple H.
If only it was after that, then Kane could have come back and said, "Well, you're a corpse fucker."
Yeah.
And that was that would have been their whole gimmick. Kane murders the victims, and Triple H fucks the corpses.
Okay. I got this. It's only Al Snow. He's the leader of the Job Squad right now. He's got his Job Squad shirt on. Pin me, pay me. That was an awesome gimmick. I love that. It was Hardcore Bob Holly, Blue Meanie, and Al Snow, the Job Squad.
Hilarious. So, well, you did it.
Yep, did off the delayed vertical
double
suplex.
Double J.
Yeah, Double J, Jeff Jarrett. Doesn't win with his finisher. He wins with the delayed vertical suplex. And let me tell you, that was no British Bulldog suplex. Although, British Bulldog was in the next game, No Mercy. That was during his shit run, right before he died.
So No Mercy was after this game?
Yes. This game is slightly more primitive, although it does have full entrances, weirdly enough. For instance, this game has no running grapple, and some of the animations are less refined.
So No Mercy, so this game came out in 2000.
This was mostly developed in 1999, and I think it was released right before WrestleMania 2000.
Okay, so really late 99.
Yeah. So. Okay, grab that calculator again. Add another 6 minutes and 4 seconds to the count. We had the shortest match on the card so far. We're
Plus
already like an hour and a half into Raw.
In 4 seconds.
Yeah, you got it?
So, yeah, we're at an hour and 2 minutes and a half.
Okay, next is Jericho versus Big Boss Man. That was a 55-minute countout. Oh my god.
Well, okay. 55 minutes and 15 seconds?
Yep. Next is not even the main event yet. Road Dogg versus The Rock. Rock wins after making him tap out after 54 minutes.
Okay, so at 54 minutes...
and 11 seconds, he made Road Dogg tap out to... I don't know, he didn't even do the sharpshooter yet at this point in his career, so he had no submissions.
Well, we're well over 2 hours now, which Raw only ran at 2 hours back then, so...
He made Road Dogg tap out to the patented side headlock.
Oh, great. Oh, wow. Well, you know that of Road Dogg.
Yeah. Next is also the not the main event, Steve Austin versus Kane. And it was a double count out 4 minutes in. What the fuck?
Great match.
I see. Wasn't it one of the only things I told you about this game is the booking is horrible? Who booked this?
The Rock and Road Dogg go at it for a fucking hour.
And then he doesn't even finish with a finisher. It's a tap out. And then Stone Cold and Kane give him 4-minute double count out. No one cares.
Well, almost 5 minutes.
All right, main event now is a tag team match. Big Show and Mankind against Triple H and Mr. Ass Billy Gunn. That's a 52-minute pinfall for Big Show and Mankind. Big Show and Mankind, by the way, were in a feud when this game was developed.
Genius.
God damn it. In fact, Big Show's very first pay-per-view match for WWE was a boiler room brawl with Mankind. Yep, it was really unsafe. Big Show was really sloppy back then.
Yeah.
Mankind was already injured, too. It was pretty bad.
Mick Foley is injuries.
Mick Foley is permanently injured, and I'm not just talking about having his ear ripped off in, like, the 80s.
No, the dude is, like, probably in constant pain.
He was Big Japan Pro Wrestling 10 years before its time. Actually, no. Big Japan Pro Wrestling would have started in the late 90s, didn't it? Oh my god, that's a scary thought. Big Japan Pro Wrestling was killing people back during the Attitude Era.
Oh, good god.
Jesus, Big Japan Pro is scary. Alright, so how long was Raw?
230 minutes!
Oh my god, it's like two pay-per-views put together back-to-back. And keep in mind, this is just the runtime of the matches. That's without promos, commercials, anything. That is, the second one man walks out of the ring, the next wrestlers get straight in. No time for an entrance.
This was like double Raw. It was like 4 hours. Good lord.
Oh, there we go. Doug says in the chat, 3 hours, 50 minutes, 7 seconds. That was not the longest. We've had Heat going for 5 hours before. Yeah. And
it's
going to
be a long
you,
Stevie night.
During this night, Chaz and Scott Taylor had a 37-minute countout match.
Yeah. Yes.
We're 9-0.
Good job.
Now for Saturday Night Heat. You know, interesting statistic. Oh, Edge is coming out. Maybe we've got our first storyline. We're getting a feud with Edge. Not bad. This would be before his tag championship. This would be when he was first leaving Gangrel.
I see.
Don't be so foolish! What the fuck?
This dialogue.
You have two choices. You can leave in one piece on your own, or you can be carried out in pieces, but I would rather make you suffer. Knock your damn lights out in front of all these people and a fuck. You know you should be more careful about what you ask for.
What the fuck are they doing? Look, did you see the gestures he was making? Hey, I'm drunk, I'm having a seizure.
They look like they're both from Blade Trinity.
Like, it looked like all they could have been possibly saying was, oh, as they were just pointing.
Just flailing their arms around, not talking into the mic.
Pumping their fists, yelling, Scooby-Doo!
Scooby-Doo! You see, you need to do Jeff Jarrett's voice during these cutscenes, because you're Southern. Can you do a good Nashville, Tennessee? Just talk about country music.
Should I just be like Hank Hill and just talk about my love?
Yeah, Jeff Jarrett's basically Hank Hill. Same thing.
I sure love Elvis.
Yeah,
damn
Hank
it.
Hill's always hitting people with acoustic guitars, right?
Terry Hart, I'm gonna kick your ass.
Hold on, I'll be back in 1 second. I'm just gonna turn a light on. It's getting dark.
Okay. He's afraid of ghosts.
I have returned.
Good.
Getting dark like Big E Langston. Alright, we're on Saturday Night Heat now. What I was going to say before about Saturday Night Heat, by the way, did you know that Saturday Night Heat and Attitude Era got more viewers on average than Raw does now?
Did you know that it's actually Sunday Night Heat?
What did I say?
Saturday?
Sorry, I always think it was Saturday because it's a better day.
But it really, yeah, it is. It really got more higher ratings than a Raw does now? Because that's pretty cool.
Higher ratings and more viewers.
Well, I mean, that makes sense. That's wrestling was in like a really good prime back that point.
Oh God, yeah, golden age for North American wrestling, in terms of viewership at least.
People it was actually relevant in popular culture at that time.
Yeah. Okay. First match, Hardy Boys Tag Team Champions against Chaz and Brian Christopher, which is Jerry Lawler's son. Why is he not tag teaming with his tag team partner, Scott Taylor, who's in the next match? Or why isn't Chaz tag teaming with his tag team partner, Mosh, of the Headbangers? What the fuck is occurring? I don't know, but tag champions win. Draws wins. Gangrel wins. God. Bradshaw murders Jericho. Makes him tap out. Wow. And next, Jarrett versus Edge. Our first feud. We're 9-0.
Oh, boy.
And his finisher at the time would be the downward spiral. So leg trapped, reverse STO. And he's got Gangrel in his corner. I got Deborah, though. I got the better manager. Mine knows how to talk. Fuck, hit me with a teleporting spear already. This would have been back when the spear was his signature. No, it's kicking my ass.
Well, technically he's flipping your ass all around, but yeah.
Yeah, this is definitely the first challenging match. No. Retreat. Yeah, strut that one off. Yeah, did you see that shit?
That epic jump off the turnbuckle in which you landed on your feet and did nothing? That was fantastic.
Man, see, this is Memphis style right here.
Yeah, miss every move.
Just gotta club him, taunt after every move that I can. Keep him out of the ring, gotta fight like a heel, you know?
Exactly.
I'm Jeff Jarrett. Bitch.
You're Double J.
Double J. I'm JEFFJARRET. Jeff Jarrett. It's really hard to get that down, by the way. I'm not nearly as fast as he is.
JARRET. That is the most annoying thing.
Yeah. Is that a southern thing? Is that why he does it? I don't know. Maybe
it's
Tennessee.
No, it's not
a
southern thing. It's more of a douchebag thing.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and again, the phantom rope breaks. But that was good, because, you know.
Ha-ha!
I love this disorienting camera.
Yeah, me too. Okay.
I really want to vomit.
Come on! I didn't even get him for a one count.
You're gonna have to bet. Dude, you got some stiff competition. You've got to at least go for 40 minutes. Ah. Holy shit.
Gravity!
He speared you, like, and missed. Then his phantom spear launched you into the barricade somehow.
Fuck you,
and
Christian.
Now you're attacking Gangrel for no reason.
Actually, I think it's Christian. They just wear the same shirt. Haha! Okay, where was he aiming? He wouldn't have hit even if I didn't move. I ran right into that. Oh, man.
Man, JEFFJARRET, you really suck.
He is killing me dead.
You really suck.
I just
noticed the stamina bar things. It says attitude.
Yeah, that's how much attitude I have. I'm getting really sassy.
Attitude era.
We need to call it sass.
His sassy pants.
His sass meter's going low. My sass is going up. I need to get him with more submissions. I'm Double J. You know?
Billy,
I gotta get that figure
ass
four leg
man, but you are the sass man.
Oh my god, yeah. I totally should have tag teamed with Billy Gunn. I'm the sass man. Fuck. Fujiwara armbar. Slide magically near the ropes. There we go. I got it with the Phantom Rope Break.
Then I slightly alter that gimmick, and he becomes the sax man, and he just has a saxophone.
He can be like an epic sax guy.
Yeah, he can be like all the name changes X-Pac went
Boom!
Through.
You know that epic sax guy 10 hours video?
Yes, I do.
Have I ever told you the story about when I watched all 10 hours? Unbroken?
No!
I took one bathroom break. And people can attest to it because I was in a call when I did it. The majority of it, at least, I was in a call. Oh my god, if I heard a single note that sounded like that song, I would get the whole song stuck in my head for every day for like a month. Apparently that's just a thing that happens with the brain. I heard a friend in high school once listened to the song Bubblegum, I think it was, no, it was Sandstorm. For like, he would only listen to Sandstorm for about a month, where that's all that was on his iPod. And he said mm-hmm. that for almost a year after. Anytime he heard any note that sounded like it could have been from that song, his brain would just start playing the rest of the song. Boo! Oh, well, that didn't do much. Hey, he's got dangerously low sass! That's my opportunity!
Get his ass!
No, I gotta do like a roll-up or something. Oh, shit.
Nice golf clap, Christian.
Good job. Good job.
Did you see Christian? Ed just falls face first in front of him. He's like, yeah, whatever, oh well.
What occurred? What occurred?
Pretty sure that if there were this many botched moves in actual wrestling, both of these men would have been fired.
Yeah, this is pretty crazy. And to the degree that these are botched. Okay, just fuck
yeah.
You. I got one punch. How can you get a rope break on an illegal maneuver?
Well, I have no idea.
All right, I'm gonna. Oh shit! I was gonna get him with a backslide. What's he doing? Wait, he's clutching his neck.
Uh-oh.
I gotta get him with a sleeper hold. That's what I gotta do.
Just a little bit more in that area and you'll retire him.
Yeah! If he just goes for the spear on Brodus Clay... Okay, I'm tag teaming with Blue Meanie. If he goes for the spear on Blue Meanie, the fat may kill him.
He'll just envelop his neck.
Oh god, he speared me! Is that it? Is his career over?
Oh god, we gotta induct him in the Hall of Fame now.
Oh god, he DDT'd me. No, oh my god, this might be my first loss. I need to do some Memphis-style heel tactics here. No! Oh my god. My
okay,
arm.
Quick. Grab an acoustic guitar.
That's a good idea, actually.
and then play it.
I grabbed a staircase out of the audience!
Okay, now play the staircase.
Fuck! No, it fell through the floor. Okay.
Okay, you're too good at playing the staircase. It phantomizes when you do it. Throw the woman in. Distract.
It's the best way I can get into the ring.
Your weird little scream just now synced perfectly with that little baseball slide you just did.
Styling like, and profiling.
It was beautiful.
Fuck the police. Yeah, that's right. Jump on me.
Don't you just love it?
Oh my god, I'm a genius. Hey, Christian.
This isn't a wrestling match anymore. Now it's just a Looney Tunes cartoon.
Huh, that's right. Go to the top rope. Fuck. I was trying to grab him to like sack him on the top.
You mean sass him?
I really want a wrestler's finisher is the sass attack. Oh, tap out. Fuck. I gotta get him with a sleeper hold. Come on, your neck can't handle it.
How did you slide to the other end of the ring?
I don't know, you'd think he would, like, walk.
Yeah, really, you'd think he'd walk to the center.
He's losing the sass is dying out of him.
You're damn
sass. Keep going for it.
His will to live is slowly decreasing.
Oh my god. I forgot, in this game it plays a horrible crunch noise. Whenever they tap out, it sounds like I broke his goddamn neck, and then he just crumples to the floor.
I love his happy face as you're murdering him.
Yeah, he just drops like a fucking rock as soon as you hear the crack. Look at the replay. Any sec- There goes. Boom! Dead weight.
You're breaking his neck, but that's making him happy because he knows that'll get him into the Hall of Fame.
Yeah! Wow, that was only an 8-minute match. I felt like it took forever. Probably because I was losing for a lot of it. Next is a triple threat intercontinental match between Godfather D'Lo Brown and Big Show. And Godfather retains after 3 minutes. Wow, that's short.
Hot dang. That was nothing.
The main event was Job Squad versus New Age Outlaws. And Job Squad taps out the New Age Outlaws during the peak of their career in 5 minutes. Whoa.
Way to go. Don't worry, they'll have their time in 15 years.
Oh, dear God. It's terrifying knowing that that's accurate.
What's even worse is the fact that they're going to main event the 30th. No, not main event. They're going to just be at the 30th WrestleMania in a match.
They did not earn that. Neither did Bautista. But 10-0, baby. Still undefeated. Double J, Jeff Jarrett. Next, we're in a tag match. Yep. Of us and the Blue Meanie versus Chaz and Brian Christopher, which are A, not a tag team, and B, a couple of jobbers.
Well, then this shouldn't be hard. Shouldn't. I like how it looks like the Blue Meanie and Jeff Jarrett just appeared.
Now, I don't know if you've ever seen Grandmaster Sexay before he was in, before they were too cool when they were too much. But he was fucking awesome. He was awesome in the light heavyweight division. He had some great matches with Taka Michinoku. Not that it's hard to have a great match with Taka Michinoku, but with how talented he is. However, their gimmick was fucking scary. Well, to be fair, Brian Christopher is a huge druggie, but... Oh my god, they were creepy as fuck. It was awesome. Alright, cool. So I actually need to be careful of Chaz here, because weirdly enough, his finisher is the Burning Hammer, which is the inverted, Death Valley Driver, the finter that Kobayashi would be the new Kenta. Kenta Kobayashi used that move only 8 times in his career. He's the inventor of the move, and every single time it was to finish a legendary match. It is probably the closest that wrestling has ever come to a death blow finisher.
Holy shit.
And it's just his fucking jobber's move. Yep. But since this was originally a Japanese game, this engine was originally made for the Virtual Pro Wrestling games in Japan, they have the Japanese animation for it. So he lands right on his neck and folds in this scary, murderous way.
Oh, that's creepy.
Oh my god, it looks like bloody murder. I do appreciate that the drop kick in this game looks as beautiful as Double J's actual drop kick. He's got one of the best drop kicks in the business.
Cool.
It's him, Hardcore Holly, and Dolph Ziggler.
Yeah, Dolph's drop kick's really great.
Yeah. Wow, his sass is all the way down.
Man, he's not a sass animal. At all, he really sucks.
Backdrop out of nowhere. No, you're not tagging.
These guys bring the same signs every fucking night.
Yeah. I like the dude in the front row near the ramp on the right side with the Austin 316 shirt and Austin 316 sign. Seems redundant.
Looks like Austin 346 to me, so... I don't know if that's an actual parable, and if it is, I kind of want to find it just to see if it says something. Wait a minute, no, of course it fucking isn't.
I like the Hello Ladies and Suck It right next to each other.
Oh, and it's mirrored on both ends, so you try to avoid it, and you go to the left side, and then it says Suck It, Hello Ladies.
I like the guy with the rock sign that's partly covered by the attitude meter, so it kind of looks like it just says Fuck. Who's the dude on the hard camera with the bright red fuck sign?
How was that allowed?
Wow. 2 minutes, 30 seconds, I beat him with a spine buster. That was easy.
Well, they were just a couple of jobbers as Double J walks into the phantom ropes.
They were a couple of jobbers, to be fair. Then again, were Jeff Jarrett and Blue Meanie. Jeff Jarrett stuck firmly in the mid-card at the time. Blue Meanie, with zero career at the time, either than just being Goldust's lackey.
Yep. Wasn't he Blue Dust at one point or something?
Yes, this would have been around when he was Blue Dust. That was a fun gimmick, though. and he feuded with Ken Shamrock, actually. Only because Goldust was, though. But still, it was a really fun thing. Speaking of Ken Shamrock, he tag-teamed with Test for some reason.
And what they both beat Steve Austin and The Rock.
Steve Austin and The Rock, well-known tag team, you know?
Yeah, you know, remember when they did the thing with the tagging and the teaming?
Yeah. By the way, chat, 11-0. Oh my god. Curtain Jerker of Sunday Night Heat. We're getting a title shot, our first title shot, for the Hardcore Championship against Al Snow.
Oh, shit.
Ooh. Ring Out is set to no DQ, which means you can do pins outside the ring.
Yes, the prestigious Hardcore Championship.
Yep.
That has changed hands about 15 million times.
Changes hands at least 3 times a night.
Yep.
Alright. Haha! Okay, now he doesn't have a manager. Ow. I walked right into that one.
Yeah, you did.
I don't know why, with this being a hardcore match, I don't know why he didn't bring his fellow Job Squad members in with him, despite how my tag team partner is actually a Job Squad member. Come on, come after me, bro.
Exactly.
Come on out. Okay, Deborah, let's do some double team moves. I don't think she's gonna help much.
She should grab him and you stab him.
Yeah, I mean, it's a hardcore match, right?
Exactly. You gotta go all out. It's Sunday Night Heat. There should be some fire involved.
Yeah, where's Stevie?
Yeah,
Stevie
for real.
Stevie would join the company around now.
That would have been a hilarious career mode.
Oh my god. Actually, there is a career mode of a game I'm doing right now where I'm Stevie.
Cool.
One of the only games he's in. I think it's the only game that he's in which you can pick him in the career mode, either than WWF No Mercy. Okay, time for the acoustic equalizer.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah!
Break it over his head. Beautiful.
Now, it doesn't Again. Break into a million pieces and look awesome, unfortunately.
Damn it.
And it falls through the floor. It wasn't until No Mercy that that the weapons would stay around. That's also when they added all the backstage places.
Oh, that was so cool.
Oh, God, it was so cool. Made the hardcore matches really fun. Because you could, like, go all around the backstage in any match.
Oh, man, I gotta tell you this story. So, me and my friends were at a convention earlier this year, a gaming convention, and there's this game there where, it's like this contest where, like, they'll play random video game music, and, like, you gotta guess, like, what game it's from to win. Yep. I wasn't one of the contestants that got picked to go up there, but, like, they played, one of the songs they played, it started like this, dig, dog, and I was like,
instant.
And I fucking stood up, and I was like, oh my god.
God,
and like
everyone's
looking at
soul.
Me, and like these are all just a bunch of generic nerds that don't know pretty much jack squat about wrestling.
Yeah.
And I was like, what the fuck? And my friend Jack was looking at me like, what? And I was like, I know that song. He's like, you do? I was like, I'm like, damn it. And then like there was only one other guy in the fucking room, and it was like had like 30, 50 people in there, and he just stood up and was like, WWF No Mercy. And then I just kind of like slow clap.
Good, because it is usually regarded as the best wrestling game. Like, most people fucking love it. Okay, I gotta put him away now. This is a pathetic match.
Yeah, this kind of blows.
The stroke is such an awesome finisher. I love it.
You really melted Al Snow there.
He didn't even get to hit me with the snowplow.
Yeah.
Hi, Chad. Usually look at chat, but I don't think they're... because it's hard for me to try to look at the chat and play. Yeah. Yeah, it's hard for me to look at the chat and play, but I'm trying to keep up on it.
I could go get out the pop-out chat.
Yeah, pop out the chat and help keep up on it. I know that Guitar Hero Jones is it, so I should be paying more attention. Fuck, I can't talk today. Was anything important in the rest of the night? No. How did Meat get a tag team match in the main event and win against the APA?
Who the hell is Meat?
Sean Stasiak in his first gimmick in WWE. Do you remember Sean Stasiak?
I've heard the name, but no.
Good. He was a WCW guy that never went anywhere.
Ah.
His gimmick was that he was trying to take Mr. Perfect's spot. Didn't work.
And they went with Meat You know what reminds me of Mr. Perfect? Steak.
Yeah. Okay, we're at King of the Ring now. King of the Ring, first match. We're defending our hardcore championship against Midian, who's the European champion. Weird.
Yeah, when that existed.
Yeah. This is also the only video game that Midian has ever been in, to my knowledge.
Uh-huh.
I liked Midian. Too bad they didn't do anything with him ever. And he's got Viscera on his side. This would be the first game for Viscera. This would be when he had lipstick on.
Ah.
Yeah. This was pre-Sex Machine and pre-Big Daddy V.
Viscera. He's dead.
He is dead. He died very recently, didn't he?
He did. It was only
a couple
like...
months ago.
Yeah,
which brings the death
ago.
Count of No Mercy up to, what, 30? More than half the roster of that game is dead now, and the game is only 14 years old. It's scary how fast people die in pro wrestling.
That's really freaking sad.
It is.
Disturbing.
It's getting a lot better now, because now in WWE they don't allow steroids, so a lot of the indie circuit guys don't do steroids because they know that they won't get into WWE if they do. So
yeah.
That has had a really positive effect on the whole industry in America.
Yep.
Oh, right! He can't get a rope break because it's a hardcore match. I could go for the figure four and just wear down his legs. I'm gonna do that. Now, Midian's finisher, this would be, he's supposed to do the eye opener, slash the slop drop, slash the problem solver, whatever gimmick he has, the eye opener at this time, but it's an inverted DDT. However, in this game, they only gave him a Canadian backbreaker for some reason, which is weird, so he's got a submission finisher.
Okay.
Which is good for him, however, entirely because of this being no rope break. Fuck!
Well, I got the pop-out chat now.
Good. Good.
Good.
Good.
Good.
Good.
Good.
It's one of my favorite things to do, and I don't know why.
Because it's just like it's a stupid word, and it's fun to say.
It is.
Good.
I don't know why stupid people use that stupid word, doofin.
Oh, well,
like,
you know what?
Doofin.
It's stupid because it's not pronounced the way it should be.
You got me with a series of really poorly... high velocity blowjob!
What?
High velocity blowjob, the diving headbutt to the groin.
Oh, okay. Thought you were telling me about last night.
No, no. Alright, Indian Deathlock. Wear down the legs. I love this move.
Oh. Hello, Sibling. One of my friends is here.
No, he's not your friend. You don't have friends. I'm your only friend. Give me your wallet. That's what friends do.
No.
That's what friends do. Give me their wallet.
No.
Just email it to me.
Email me your bitcoins at www.fuckyou.com.
Okay, he's
email me
leg.
Your bitcoins at www.cockapitta.com. Thank you, Doug, for reminding me of the cockpitta.
Still not as great as the cock pounce. There are a lot of cock-related wrestling stories. Come on, tap. 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 Aww. I just gotta keep knocking him down. He's giving me a lot of trouble considering it's Midian.
Yeah, I didn't even know who that was.
He's one of the lowest stat dudes in the game. Come on. Keep putting him in the figure. This is one of my goddamn finishers. How's he getting out of it so easy?
Now stomp his head.
There we go. Yeah, it snapped. His shin's broken.
Well, that's another good... There's another retiree.
Yeah, he'll be out for a good 9 months.
And then just phantom walk into the ropes to celebrate.
Apparently, I made Donta laugh so hard that his back is acting up.
Well, there's another retiree.
Yep.
Madry Brad just keeps retiring people.
That was only a 4-minute match. So again, we're at a pay-per-view here. We're having matches like Chaz versus Steve Blackman. Gerald Briscoe versus Val Venus. What the fuck? Gerald Briscoe being a member of Creative, even back then. What the fuck? And this was also the first game that Albert / Prince Albert / A-Train / Great Bernard / Giant Bernard / Lord Tensai / Tensai / Jason to Albert was in.
Oh my god, just stop.
He's had a lot of names. You know he had a name change again, like, last month?
You mean, like, what was it, like... Wait, last month?
Yeah, he had another name change.
To what?
Jason Albert. Apparently, Albert's now his last name. It's not his real name, by the way. His real name's Matt Bloom.
He
does commentary for NXT. He's actually pretty good.
Cool.
Yeah. And next is a 3-minute match of Shane McMahon, Vince McMahon, and Triple H. What the fuck?
Yeah, that makes sense.
Especially now. Yeah, totally makes sense. And next, oh my god, I was in the current jumper and I'm in the tournament.
Makes sense.
If I win this...
Ooh.
If I win this, I get a title shot at the world title.
Oh shit, you better do it or I'm gonna slap you.
No, is that what you get for... I don't remember. That's
do
what you're supposed to get.
Or do you just, are you just the King of the Ring?
In a Royal Rumble... Alright, this is a King of the Ring match. In the King of the Ring match, when you become the King of the Ring, I think what it does is it beelines you ahead in, like... The game has, like, an invisible popularity system, I think it does, of, like, determining how good you are that basically takes in wins and losses. I think winning King of the Ring counts for, like, a ton of points.
Cool.
Okay, so first it's Rock versus Undertaker. Taker wins. D'Lo Brown versus Road Dogg. Aw, Road Dogg wins. Edge versus Test. Test wins. And I'm against The Big Show.
That's fair. Oh my god, he's naked.
Yes, he's naked and has a ponytail.
The Big Show, aka The Big Show.
Oh god. We're in the feeling out process now.
Epic stare down. Let's just slip and slide around while we look at each other.
This action-packed music. And this match is up to a rip-roaring start. I can do this as long as you can show, damn it. That was a dirty move. I wasn't ready.
an old Western slip and slide stare down.
Uh-huh. Retreat!
Now lift him up, because that will be very easy.
Haha! Parkour! 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 Haha!
That's Spider-Man's new catchphrase now, by the way.
Whee! Oh my god.
Just do like Homer Simpson in that one episode and just try to tire him out.
I didn't even touch him. Okay.
Oh,
I'm seriously gonna have to come up with some kind of technique to beat this because it's the fucking Big Show.
Okay, go get. Okay.
No!
A knife.
Ha ha! I got a guitar! Oh shit! It went into the ether!
It went to hell, damn it.
Oh god.
God, Big Show's hair looks so awful.
It's terrible. Whoa!
Wow, they really couldn't have booked you any worse.
MSX just said, I love how you're parkouring while I'm playing Mirror's Edge.
I need to play Mirror's Edge.
God! That was a good running start!
Your grunts are so well-timed.
Oh my god, I'm killing this man. Why isn't the guitar breaking?
It just keeps replaying his death over and over again.
Get out of my fucking ring, Paul. As soon as he gets back in here.
There are so many wrestlers and wrestling-associated people named Paul.
I know! It's crazy!
Wrestling loves Pauls.
Paul Cena, Triple Paul. See, one of my favorite things to do is when you hear two badass wrestling names and it's like, that's the main event for the WWE Championship, refer to them only by their real first name and it becomes a hell of a lot funnier. Instead of CM Punk versus Triple H, it's Phil versus Paul for the WWE Championship.
Daniel versus Paul.
And no, it would be Brian versus Paul.
Oh, wait, it would be Brian versus Paul. Yeah, that's right.
It's Daniel Bryanson.
Yeah, no, it's Brian Danielson.
No, Daniel Bryanson's my favorite thing to call him.
Daniel.
If you're gonna fuck with the name, so will I, WWE.
Well, then that's just Japanese. Then you might as well just call him American Dragon.
There you go.
It all comes back. It all circles around.
Oh god! He doesn't even need to try. He's headbutting me in the back of the head. Instant concussion. Oh dear god! Oh dear god!
That's not right. He's not allowed to do that. He kills people if he does that.
What? Come at me. Yeah! Retreat.
This is the opportunistic way of wrestling.
Yes.
Just run away and run around and tie your opponent out.
It's effective, you see?
Exactly.
He's
wait for everyone else to beat each other up, then
the
get the win.
I've got the sass.
You've got the sass.
We're back to this again.
Okay. That lets you know that it's halftime.
Idea?
Because you never have that in wrestling.
Oh god. Oh god, I was about to say idea, get him in the corner. Oh god, that's a lot of weight. He's gonna break my ribs.
Didn't really work out in your favor there.
Oh god, like 500 pound leg drop on the back of the head. Get in the corner. Oh my god, you're telling me that the Big Show has this kind of technical expertise. Oh my god, no! Violation!
I'm calling human rights on this.
Oh god.
Okay, just all sorts of wrong.
His sass is going down.
Dude, his sass is through the roof.
Oh god, I might lose this match. And spinal fracture.
You're never going to be able to create TNA at this rate.
It's like a bulldozer.
Distract him with your manager. Oh, he almost ran out of the arena.
Let me just build up a lot of speed. What is he doing?
He's taunting you with his slowness.
I missed. Yeah.
You're brilliant.
Shit. No!
Not this again.
Okay.
Oh man!
I still have one
my
kidney
screen
left.
My screen froze in midair, so. Oh, god.
Okay.
Yeah, you're pretty fucked.
I'm
right
not
now.
Sure how I'm gonna beat him. Fucking tap.
Just do what my brother would do with No Mercy and just take him out of the ring all the time.
I think that you can do out of the ring pins in this. In this match. I'm not sure if there's no count out, I know that for sure. Which was not an actual King of the Ring rule, by the way.
Yeah. The backstory behind the Big Show, well, he's big. And that's about it. And sometimes he's a show, sometimes not, though.
Yeah. Okay, I got the guitar. That worked out pretty well for me last time. Is he gonna dive?
Just hit him while he got out.
He's going for a base. No. No. No.
God, he did a Memphis reverse.
Oh my god.
Yeah, you're in some bad shape, mister.
How many guitars can I find? Trash bin.
Time to take out the trash.
I'm not Duke the Dumpster Drossy. Do you remember him?
Oh.
His gimmick was that he was a garbage man, and that was his...
Fuck him.
I think that... He was also a wrestler, actually, although I think he's also a drug dealer nowadays. I'm pretty sure he was busted for that, like, a year ago. Awesome wrestler, stupid, but awesome gimmick at the same time. I swear to God, probably the only reason his gimmick was made was so that you could have a dude's catchphrase before his finisher be, "It's time to take out the trash!" And everyone cheers.
That's 80s as hell.
No,
I love the shadows on the floor that just look like blobs.
Huh.
Finally.
And now it is time for my comeback.
As you get kneed in the face and then run.
Can't catch me. Fuck. Yes. Yes! What now? Big Show!
Yeah, where's
not
your show
so
now?
Big now!
Your show's about to get canceled!
Fuck. Yeah! Can't believe he didn't just catch me.
He was too busy holding his broken neck.
Oh my God, thank you for pointing that out. I didn't realize he had a neck injury. I'm going for it.
Sweet.
That's how we're gonna win this. He's bad at submissions, which means I can lock him in for a long time. I don't know if there's rope break in this match. I hope not. Oh my God, my sass is getting high. I got a lot of sass. I got a lot of sass.
Get your sass on.
Come on. Roll him up.
Sass,
roll him up.
Motherfucker.
Yes. No, only got him for a one count. Jesus.
Man, he's tough.
I'm gonna steal a finisher.
His show just got renewed for a second season.
No! I lost my sass meter! No, I was gonna steal a finisher. Fuck.
You're okay. You just gotta focus. Think wax on and then also the wax off.
You can go wax off, Paul. Oh my God, he does feel like a final boss.
We just need more epic music.
He's the preliminary match. They put me against a tough guy. Oh,
this
oh
is
my
the
God.
Final. The fina- This is the finale.
That this fucking is- headbutt. Deborah.
Dude.
Deborah,
what
are you doing?
What is
he
doing?
Oh my God, Jericho. Oh my God, there's a run-in. Is he against me? He's against me. Are you kidding
you're
me?
Screwed in your butt.
Okay, Deborah. Deborah, you
areas.
Fight him. I got the Big Show. Big Show. Oh my God, he's hitting his double powerbomb on Deborah. Jericho, you piece of shit.
You asshat.
You know what? Deborah, you just take care of that. I've got enough to worry about with the Big Show, as Lillian Garcia calls him. It's one of my favorite Lillian Garcia fuck-ups. The Big Show.
My mom was actually in a beauty pageant with Lillian Garcia.
Oh. Did she
and
win?
And my mom won.
That's awesome.
Yeah, fuck you, Lillian Garcia. My genes are more pure.
Yeah. Oh, right in the face. He shouldn't have ducked.
He should have jumped. Took it with his gut.
Yeah. Okay.
Now get in the
what
fucking
are you
room.
Thinking?
Hold on, I want to get up here. No, wait, never mind.
Fucking jump like RVD across the entire ring.
He do a fucking 5-star frog splash and he's the Big Show.
Okay, I think I have like broken ribs.
This is a slobber. Oh my God, you did it.
Oh my God, I did it. That's
you somehow won and now let's just walk on his broken ankles.
Dante says match of the fucking year. Oh my God, it feels like it. My hands can tell you how difficult a match that was. And
that was
I
Mario
like
Party
fucking...
1 levels of hand pain.
Yeah, I fought like a fucking heel the whole time. I had to. Did you see how hard that was?
That was really fucking hard.
Oh my God. Oh my God, chat, big ups. 12-0.
Aw, yeah.
Now, is this whole tournament going to count as one match? Or as however many matches it takes? Because if it counts as one match, fuck you.
Yeah, that's a bunch of ass.
Whoa, Road Dogg just beat The Undertaker.
Yeah, sure, that'll happen,
Okay, now it's Test. Now, Test is tough. This was during one of his big pushes. But I feel like he's not as tough as Big Show. At the time, Test's finisher would be the Gut Wrench Powerbomb.
What
and
is
the pump
happening with your arm?
It's having a little bit of...